Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to all of you. This is Spanish Language Series, Episode 61, Infinitives Made Finite. So these are the contents which we are going to cover in today's session. The Spanish infinitive and its principal uses. The three uses, so we are going to discuss each one of them. The first use is infinitive as a noun. The second use is infinitives with finite verbs. And the third use is infinitive with idiomatic expressions. And finally, we'll see some important adjectives for vocabulary. So let's start. The Spanish infinitive and its principal uses. An infinitive is a verb that is not inflected. In other words, it does not change in any form by inflection. In grammar, inflection takes place when a verb changes in form according to whether the subject of the sentence is singular in the first, as in yo, second, as in tú, or third, as in usted, él, or ella. Person or plural like nosotros, and according to the conjugated form of the verb in a particular tense, such as the present, preterite, imperfect, and future. An infinitive is generally considered to be a mood and it does not refer to a particular person, number, or tense. It is indeterminate and general. It is not conjugated in the tenses. The verb, however, is inflected because it is conjugated in the various tenses and changes in form. An infinitive remains in the same form as in hablar, comer, and vivir. In English, an infinitive is recognized by the preposition to in front of it, as in to speak, to eat, or to live. When conjugated, to speak changes to he or she speaks, I spoke, or we have spoken, etc. The change in the verb form is called inflection. The form of an infinitive is always the same because it is not conjugated and it is not inflected. Okay, so the first use is infinitive as a noun. So an infinitive can be used as a noun and it is masculine in gender. In English, we can use the present participle of a verb to function as a noun, in which case we call it as a gerund. In Spanish, however, the infinitive form of a verb is used. For example, if I want to say reading is good, I'm going to say leer es bueno or el leer es bueno. Now reading is leer or el leer. Good is bueno. And is S. Let's take another example. Smoking is not good for one's health. Fumar no es bueno para la salud. Now smoking is fumar. Is not good is no es bueno. For the health is para la salud. Now for one's health loosely becomes para la salud, which literally means for the health. Infinitives with finite verbs. This is the second use. So an infinitive is used with some finite verbs, those that are conjugated in the various tenses when affirmation or belief is conveyed. Let's take an example. If I want to say Mary always believes she is right, I'm going to say María siempre cree tener razón. Now always is siempre, believes is cree, she is right becomes tener razón, which literally means she has right. Let's take another example. We can come to your house tonight. It becomes nosotros podemos venir a tu casa esta noche. Now tonight becomes esta noche, which literally means this night or this evening. Your house is tu casa. Come is venir. Podemos is can. And we is nosotros. The third uses infinitive with idiomatic expressions. So an infinitive can be used with idiomatic expressions that contain ke or de. Let's take some examples. So if I want to say I have a lot to do this morning, I'm going to say tengo mucho que hacer esta mañana. I have a lot is tengo mucho. To do this morning is hacer esta mañana. Morning is mañana. This is esta. Hacer is to do. Let's take another example. My friends have just arrived. Mis amigos acaban de llegar. My friends becomes mis amigos. Have just arrived becomes acaban de llegar. Now arrived is llegar. Okay, FII, an idiom is a group of words established by usage as having a meaning not deducible from those of the individual words. For example, over the moon, see the light, etc. Okay, now vocabulary and adjectives part 4. Happy is alegre, hard is duro, hardworking is trabajador, healthy is sano, heavy is pesado, high is alto, hot is caliente, in a good mood is de buen humor, kind is simpatico, last or latest is ultimo, lazy is perezoso, light is ligero, lively is animado, local is local, locked is cerrado, long is largo. Okay guys, this was it for this session. I hope you liked the video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next session and please subscribe to my channels.